anytime that the running backs, you're always concerned with the running backs. I mean, you already see it this year. I mean, you saw it last year. When we lost, we had three guys at one time go down last year. And so we're always concerned with that. And I think some guys have a little bit of innate knack for, call it luck, call it instincts, call it whatever, a little bit of luck. I mean, it's all those things. But Miles is also very put together. I mean, he doesn't look like your normal freshman. He's a little bit vertically challenged, but other than that, put together. And he holds up well.
In a game like that, what's the protocol to not really running up the score and making the other team bad?
Well, I think one thing is it's good to get other guys in. I mean, I kind of said that before. I mean, that doesn't happen too much, in the schedule that we play. And those kids that got in the game, I'm telling you, they work just as hard as those starters do. And so to be able to get them some work is good because there's nothing like game reps. So that's really good. And you work on your base type packages, I know that they're a lot happier at practice today than they were last week, so that's all good.
Is there any temptation that, okay, you've got KJ in for a whole half now, maybe let him throw a few passes, but obviously you don't want to run it up, but is there any temptation to let him throw it a few times? Or?
I mean, yeah, sometimes you'd like to do that, but we seem to be getting decent field position and all those things, and so there's still other things to work on, to pay attention to. We got a long way to go, and you know how we feel about the run game and staying balanced and those things. And so, I know all quarterbacks want to get out there and wing it, but there's a time and place for all that.
Chris, regarding the opening kickoff lateral, how excited was the team when they heard you were going to do that, and was that a big point of it to get these guys really engaged?
You know, that's a good question. They really didn't make a big deal about it. You know, Coach Choate had said the other day in the meeting, hey, we're going to open up with this. And I didn't hear any rumblings or anything like that. You know, we always have a bunch of things in our back pocket, and we've held on to a lot of things. And so I think maybe sometimes they think, oh, here goes another one that we're not going to get to. But I think he and I felt really comfortable with it. You know, we had done that before. It's, looks like trickery and all those things, but it's actually a pretty good way to make sure the field stays balanced. And I think the two guys that were operating it, you put something like that in, they spend extra time at practice, you don't even have to talk to them. They're out there on their own, turn the lights off when you get this thing right. And that's what's always fun about those type of plays.
And the strategy to have Clatcher lay down, has that always been what you've done in this play?
Yeah. So we let them, I don't want to give away too many details, but they can, let the ball get kicked and then go get small. And maybe not let them see. I mean, sometimes the ball hangs up. Depending on the coverage, you can get the ball up, carry the ball a little bit longer. So they really kind of collapse on the ball carrier. And the thrower's got to have a good sense of, I better get this thing out. And it's got to be backwards. And they did a good job with it.
And how do you coach that? Getting on the field and then laying down.
Well, you kind of work on the timing and all those things. You want the ball to get up in the air. They're all converging where the ball's going, and so hopefully they take their eyes off the other returner. And, just in case somebody sees something from the side, you have to lay down, sneak out when you can. It doesn't hurt when you're in white uniforms and the numbers are white, so you.
You wouldn't have done it if we were in purple.
We've done it. It just helps. It just helps.
Yeah. And Chris, how do you balance the narrative of the rivalry game and with the team just really staying with their focus on what they need to do?
Yeah.
Trying to stay away from that distraction, if you can call it.
Yeah. Well, I think there's a lot of distractions going on this week. I really do. We have Thanksgiving, which gives us and we're playing on a short week. A lot of parents coming in. We have senior night. There were banquet shortly, so there's a lot of different things going on. So we've kind of addressed it, but I think we got to also use it just as a positive. There's a lot of excitement going on. That all these games at the end of the year to play your rival and all those things. That's all good. That's all fun. And I hope they feel. I hope they feel it's. There's a different energy in those type of things.